Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, I would like to go over some advanced logic inside of the if statement. About a month or two ago, we did a nested if statement video if you would like to check that. But today, we are going to handle the operators of and as well as or and see how you can use those two words inside of your logical statement to be able to evaluate the values of a cell using certain criteria. So let's review the spreadsheet that we are going to be using for this lesson. I've created a spreadsheet of vendors, and my vendors are being evaluated on three different criteria. And that criteria is how good are they, meaning how many mistakes do they have? How fast are they, meaning how many days does it take to get my order? And how cheap are they, evaluating the price that they are charging me? So if you look over here on the right, in order to be in the good category, the vendor is going to need to have less than three mistakes. In order to be in the fast category, the vendor is going to need to deliver my product in less than 14 days. And in order to be cheap, it's going to have to cost less than $5,000. So in column C, I'm keeping track of all of the mistakes, which need to be less than three. In column D, I'm keeping track of the response days, which needs to be less than 14. And in column E, I'm keeping track of how much their product costs, which needs to be less than $5,000. So first, I'd like to evaluate whether or not this vendor meets at least one of these criterion. And in order to do that, I'm going to use the logical statement or. So think about this for a minute. They would meet at least one criterion if their number of mistakes is less than three, or their number of response days is less than 14, or the amount that it costs is less than $5,000. So that would be a vendor that meets at least one of these criterion. So how do I write that? I'm going to click in cell F3 and I'm going to type equals if in a left parenthesis. The very first thing I want to do here for my logical test is I want to type the word or with another left parenthesis. Now you can see the or function is going to take logical tests. So my first logical test is my number of mistakes right here in cell C3 less than number of allowable mistakes over here in L2. And then I'm going to type a comma and I'm going to go to my second logical test, which is going to be, is my number of response days less than the 14 response days that I want to have? And then finally, I'm going to type a comma and I want to know if my amount, which I'm going to have a difficult time clicking in because my formula is spilling over. So I'm going to use my down arrow and then the left arrow and then the up arrow so that I can get to cell F3. And I'm going to say, is that less than the amount that I have for cheap? Okay, now I'm going to close the parentheses on the or, and now I'm back to my if statement. So if at least one of these is valid, then I'm going to want to return the word yes. So I'm going to type a comma, and for my value of true, I'm just going to type a double quote and put in the word yes. And then if this is not true, I'm going to type a double quote, put in the word no. And then I'm going to close my parentheses for the if statement, and I'm going to hit enter. And as you can see, since my data is formatted as a table, this has automatically autofilled to all of the cells beneath it. But let's look at my autofill here. I can see that it's saying no towards the bottom, but that's not correct because if I look over here at vendor number 22 on line 24, this vendor is actually meeting two of my three criteria. So there should be a yes in here. So what's going on down there? If I go on to vendor 22, when I look up here, I can see that my cell was not locked and it is comparing something in L23, L24, and L25, and I have nothing in there. So I really want this to only be comparing to L2, L3, and L4. So if I go up here and I click where the L2 is and I hit F4, notice that dollar signs were put in here. That means that cell is going to be locked. If I do the same for L3, I just hit function F4 and do the same thing for L4 and hit function F4 and then hit enter, you will see that my formula has now been correctly updated. If I go back down to vendor 22 right here, you will see that it is now pulling from L2, L3, and L4. And that is exactly what I do want. So I can see that a lot of my vendors are meeting my requirements at least on one criterion. Now, how about if I go over here to all three criteria? In the one criterion case, I used an or because I just wanted to know if they were meeting on this or this or this. In order to meet all three criteria, they would have to meet on number of mistakes and response days and the amount. So if I go over here and I copy my formula, my if statement, hit escape and go to all three criteria and I paste my formula up there, all I'm going to do is change the word or here to an ands and hit enter. And now I will see that I only have a couple of vendors that are actually meeting my criteria on all three categories. So over here, I want to do a ranking, and my ranking here is going to be a simple if statement. So I'm going to type if a left parenthesis, this cell equals yes, then I want to return excellent. Otherwise, I want to return something else. But for now, I'm just going to put N/A because I have not evaluated this completely yet. And I'm going to hit enter. So I can see right now that I only have three vendors that are meeting all of my criteria. So those are probably my star vendors, and I want to put them in a separate category. I'm also going to include a little chart over here that says how much of my criteria do I need to get the excellent rating, the good, the fair, and the poor. The three is excellent, the two is good, the one is fair, and the zero is poor. We will be using these words over here to evaluate what kind of ranking the vendor gets. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. Okay, so you can see that the at least one criterion is relatively simple because I can just use the OR function, and all three criteria is rather simple because I can just use the ands operator inside of the if statement. But what about two criteria right here? I'm going to click in G3, and I'm going to first evaluate how many criteria are being met. So I'm going to first do that like this. I'm going to say equals a sum. And what am I going to sum up? I'm going to actually use my if statement to return a 1 if the criterion is met, and I'm going to use a 0 if it is not. So that's going to take three if statements right here. The first if statement will be if my number of mistakes is less than my requirement over here in L2, then I'm going to return a 1, comma, otherwise I'm going to return a 0, and I'm going to close that parenthesis. That is the first number that I'm going to sum. The second number I am going to sum, I'm going to type a comma, and then I bet you can guess what I'm going to do next. It's going to be if, left parenthesis, my response days are less than my required response days, then if that's true, I'm going to return a 1, and if it is not, I'm going to return a 0. I'm going to close that if statement with a parenthesis, and I'm going to type a comma for my final evaluation, which is going to be if, and my logical test here is going to be amount. Again, I can't click on it because my formula is spilling over into the column that I need, so I'm just going to press the down arrow and move over with the arrows on the keyboard and go up to my amount field. So if my amount is less than the number that I have over here, I'm going to return a 1, otherwise it will be a 0, and I'm going to close my parenthesis for the if statement. But I'm also going to close it now for the sum. But again, to remind you that I want to lock cells L2, L3, and L4. First of all, before I hit enter and my formula is copied all the way down to the bottom, I'm going to click on L2 and hit function F4 to put the dollar signs in for L2. Same for L3, I'm going to hit function F4. And same for L4, I'm going to hit function F4. And now when I press enter on the keyboard, I will see that some of these cells are receiving a 2, some a 1, and some a 0. So if I go back and I click on G3 again, I really in this column want to return a yes if it is 2 and a no if it's anything besides 2. So let's guess how I would do that. I would just put another if statement in. So I'm going to put an if statement in the very front. So if this whole formula up here is a 2, then I want to return yes. Otherwise, I want to return no. So I'm going to click in between the equal sign and the word sum and type if with a left parenthesis. I'm going to go to the very end of that entire formula and put in equals 2, because if this column equals 2, then I have two matching criteria. Then I want to return the word yes. Otherwise, I want to return the word no. Close my quotes, close my parentheses, and hit enter. And as you can see, now the word yes is appearing when two criteria are met. Okay, so now that I've evaluated for at least one criterion, two criteria, and all three criteria, now I can use this chart over here for a more accurate ranking for each one of my vendors. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to type in I3, and I'm going to use a different function here. One of our earlier videos this year, we used a function called IFS. And that's what we are going to use today. So we're going to use equal IFS with a left parenthesis. And what this function does is it evaluates different logical tests in sequence. But in order to do that, I first want to evaluate if all three criteria are met, and then all two criteria, and then at least one criterion. Because if I don't do that, if I start with the lowest first, I will have the scenario where I will simultaneously meet one criterion and all three. So what I want to do is start at the highest level and work my way down because I want the first logical test to be evaluated first. And in this case, that first logical test is going to be what I have in cell H2. If H2 is yes and all three criteria have been met, I want to return the word excellent over here. So what I'm going to do is go over to cell H2, and I'm going to say that if all three criteria equals the word yes in double quotes, then I'm going to type a comma, and I want to return this word right here that I have in this cell in K6. That's my first logical test. So if all three criteria are met, I'm going to return the word excellent. Next, I'm going to evaluate if two of my criteria are met. I'm going to do that by putting a comma, and you will see that I have logical test number two. So I'm going to click on what is in G3. If that equals yes, that means two criteria have been met, and I'm going to type a comma, and I'm going to return this word right here for two criteria being met. And then I'm going to type a comma and do the same thing for if this cell equals yes, then I want to return the word that is in this cell right here. And then finally, if what's in this cell equals no, that means no criteria have been met. So I'm going to return what is in this cell right here. I'm going to close the parentheses for the IFS. And before I hit enter, again, I want to go to everything in K6 and hit function F4. Because I want to lock that cell down. Same with K7, K8, and K9. And I'm going to hit enter. And now let's just spot check some of my data. Is this first one is fair or correct? Yes, because it only has one criterion. It doesn't have two. How about this one right here? This has two but not three, so it should be good. And let's go to this excellent. It has all three, so that one should be marked excellent. And if I go down here to poor, I will see that all three categories get a no, so that is correctly marked. So it seems that our spreadsheet is functioning correctly. If you'd like to have a little bit of fun with this, instead of using excellent, good, fair, poor, you could use some emojis. So click in where it says excellent, and if you hit the Windows key plus the period, this emoji window will appear. So let's say excellent, we want the big grinning face. Good, stick that one in and hit enter. Say for good, we would like hit the Windows key and the period, and we could put the regular smiling face and then click on the next cell. If we hit Windows period again, let's say for the fair person, you're kind of thinking about it. So we're going to use this little thinking face down here and then click on the cell that says poor and hit Windows period. And in this case, we don't want to deal with them. It makes it very difficult to deal with them. So we're going to put the nauseated face. Click on this cell down here, and you will see that this has been updated to emojis instead of the words excellent, good, fair, and poor. So that's your call on what you would like to do there. So in review today, we covered how to use some advanced if functions. We covered the or statement within an if statement. We covered the and statement within an if statement. We went back over making a nested if statement, and we also went over how to use the IFS statement again in order to evaluate how well we liked our vendors. Hopefully you learned something new today and look forward to seeing you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.